Did you know if you swear in the first 7 seconds of your video or just swear too much throughout your video, it will get demonetized? Don't risk it. Censor it out. Hi, my name is Serge, and on this channel, we try to help you make the most out of your equipment and software and tell a more engaging story by making better videos. If you make videos for YouTube, they recently updated their profanity policy. It now states that profanity used in the title, thumbnails, or in the video's first 7 seconds, or used consistently throughout the video, may not receive ad revenue. The easiest way to get around this is not to swear in your video. But if you accidentally let an F-bomb slip out, the next best thing you can do is censor it out. Today, I'm going to show you how you can do that in Final Cut Pro. First, let's take a look at how to bleep out your audio. Switch your timeline to waveform view, skim your clip, and locate the waveform of the swear you want to censor out. To make this easier, add a marker at the start and at the end of your waveform. Go to your sound effects browser and find the sound effect you want to use to censor your swear. I'm going to use the censor beep sound effect I got from Envato Elements. That's where I get most of my sound effects. Connect this effect to your timeline, line up the start of the waveform with your first marker, and trim off the end at your second marker. Use the audio fade handle to fade it out at the end. Next, we need to turn down the audio in our video clip. Press R on your keyboard to switch to the range tool. Click and drag out a range in your timeline between the markers and drag the volume line all the way down. Repeat these steps for any other swears you might have in your video. Here's what we have so far. Did your new video get f***ing demonetized again? These new policies are well, not really, but it is frustrating. Next, just to be on the safe side, let's censor out the subject's mouth. You have a couple options for this. First is you can use the built-in censor effect. If your subject doesn't move much throughout the shot, this is the easiest way to do it. Place your playhead on the first marker and go back one frame. Open the effects browser and search for the censor effect. Add this to your clip. In the video inspector, let's change the method to rectangle, resize it, place it over our subject's mouth, and change the aspect ratio. With your playhead one frame before your marker, bring the amount slider all the way down to zero and add a keyframe. Move your playhead ahead one frame so it's on the marker and bring the amount slider all the way up. Move to your second marker and add a keyframe to the amount slider. Move one frame ahead and bring the amount all the way down to zero. This takes care of our first swear. Now, the problem with using the censor effect is if you need to track it to a moving subject, it doesn't work that great. So, for our next couple swears, let's place an emoji over our subject's mouth and track it to follow the movement. In my media browser, I have a PNG image I'm going to use for this. Place your playhead on the first marker, grab your PNG image, and drag it into the viewer window over your subject's face. Up at the top, select Transform, resize this image, and place it over your subject's mouth. Open the Tracker dropdown, and deselect Rotation. In my experience, tracking rotation does more harm than good. Select Tracker and click the Analyze button to track your clip. This tracks the entire clip, so like in my example, if you have more swears to censor out, you'll be able to use the same tracker for the rest of your swears. Once the track is complete, ripple trim the end of your clip to the second marker. Grab the same clip from the media browser and place it over the next part of your clip you need to censor. Ripple trim the end to your second marker. Select the Transform tool, resize the emoji, and place it over your subject's mouth. Open the Tracker dropdown, select the face track from before, and deselect Rotation. Since the entire clip is already tracked, you don't need to analyze it again. Did your new video get f***ing demonetized again? These new policies are well, not really, but it is f***ing frustrating. This is one of many uses for the built-in object tracker in Final Cut Pro. If you want to learn what else you can do with it, I made a video on my top 5 uses for the object tracker in Final Cut Pro. Click here to watch it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.